Now that we've figured out what our space of periodic functions is, we can get to work diagonalizing some of our favorite Hermitian operators on the space of functions. So we're going to do the second derivative in this video, and we're going to do minus I times the first derivative in the next video. So second derivative, we already established that it's Hermitian, so all the eigenvalues have to be real. And I claim that none of them are positive. And I'm going to give you two proofs of this. The first proof is slick and abstract. So let's suppose that you had a positive eigenvalue. So in other words, the second derivative of f was a positive multiple of f. Then 0 would be less than the inner product of f with lambda f, because this is just lambda times the inner product of f with itself, and lambda is positive. But lambda f is the second derivative of f. And now we use the fact that the adjoint of the first derivative is minus the first derivative. We take this first derivative and we push it over to the other side where it becomes a minus first derivative. But now we have minus the inner product of f prime with f prime. But the inner product of f prime with itself has to be positive or at least zero. So we get something that can't be positive. Well, that's a contradiction. We had a positive number that's less than or equal to zero. Bzzz, no good. And so you can't have any positive eigenvalues. Now, we could also look for positive eigenvalues, in which case, of course, we're not going to find any. So here's the direct search for positive eigenvalues. Suppose we had a positive number. Any positive number can be written as a square. So if kappa squared is a positive eigenvalue, then our function would have to solve second derivative of f is lambda f. In other words, second derivative of f is kappa squared times f. But we know what the solutions to second derivative equals kappa squared f are. They're Cauches and Cinches of kappa x. And then, and if you look at the f prime, well, derivative of Cauche is kappa Cinch. Derivative of Cinch is kappa Cauche. And now we set f of 0 equal to f of L. F of 0 is C1 times 1 plus C2 times 0, which is C1. F of L is this expression. So this gives us an equation for C1 and C2. If you set f prime of 0 and f prime of L to be the same, that gives you another equation for C2. This is actually the equation for f prime of 0 divided by kappa is equal to f prime of L divided by kappa. You put those two equations together, you see you can put the C1 on the other side by saying C1 times Cauche minus 1. And this is the matrix form of those equations. Now, when can you find a non-trivial solution to a matrix M times a vector equals 0? You can find a non-trivial solution if and only if the determinant of M is 0. So let's compute the determinant. The determinant is Cauche minus 1 times Cauche minus 1, which is Cauche squared minus 2 Cauche plus 1, minus Cinch squared. But Cauche squared minus Cinch squared is 1, so we get 2 minus 2 Cauche. And the Cauche is always bigger than 1, so 2 minus 2 Cauche is negative. In particular, it's not 0. Since m is invertible, the only solution to this equation is C1 equals C2 equals 0. In other words, the only solutions to our eigenvalue equation are the zero function, so this can't be an eigenvalue. So there we go, no positive eigenvalues. Well, what about zero as an eigenvalue? If zero is an eigenvalue, then the second derivative of f must be zero, which means f must be a constant plus another constant times x. And now, and the derivative of f is going to be the second constant. So the equation f of 0 equals f of L tells you that C2 has to be 0. It says C1 equals C1 plus C2 L. So C2 is 0. And if C2 is 0, then, well, the second equation is all automatically satisfied because this is C2 and this is C2. Doesn't tell us anything new. So you need C2 is 0. You need to get rid of that. But the function f of x equals a constant works. It is an eigenvector, with eigenvalue 0. There's 1 and 1. F of x is a constant, which is to say our basis eigenvector is just the function 1. Finally, we look for negative eigenvalues. And now we want lambda to be minus k squared. So our second derivative is minus k squared times f. And the solution to that is not cosh's and sinh's, but cosines and sines of kx. You take derivatives and you get minus sines and cosines. You set f of l equal to f of 0. And you get this expression. You set f prime of l and f prime of 0 divided by kappa, but divided by k, and you get this expression. In other words, you have a matrix times a coefficients equals 0. It's behaving just like the cosh's and sinh's, except we have cosines instead of cosh's, sines instead of sinh's, and this is a minus sine instead of a plus sinh. And now we take the determinant of our matrix. It's cosine minus 1 squared plus sine squared. So that's cosine squared minus 2 cosine plus 1 plus sine squared. That's 2 minus 2 cosine. But unlike the hyperbolic case, there are solutions here. There are values of k for which cosine of kl is 1. That happens whenever kl is a multiple of 2 pi, which means that k has to be a multiple of 2 pi over l. Great. So k is a multiple of 2 pi over l, and lambda is minus that squared. And when that happens, M is just the zero matrix. C1 and C2 can be whatever they want. And both cosine and sine of kx wind up being solutions. So, in summary, our eigenvalues are 0, minus 4 pi squared over L squared, minus 16 pi squared over L squared, minus 36 pi squared over L squared, minus 64 pi squared over L squared, in general, minus 4n squared pi squared over L squared. The zero eigenvalue has multiplicity 1, and the only eigenfunction are the constants, that is, a constant times 1. Minus 4 pi squared n squared over L squared has multiplicity 2, and we get two functions. You can have cosine of 2 pi n x over L, or you can have sine 2 pi n x over L. Now, a lot of people lump in the function 1 together with the cosines because the cosine of 0x is just 1. So what's often done is you talk about the functions being cosine of 2 pi nx over L, where n is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Because when n equals 0, you get the function 1. And sine 2 pi nx over L, where here n starts with 1. And these functions are orthogonal. Because our matrix was Hermitian, we get an orthogonal basis for the eigenspace. You consider them for all n, and you get an orthogonal basis for the entire vector space.